there may be problems with the S26's development that lead Samsung to delay its release. You might have to wait longer than you thought for your new Samsung flagship. Samsung might be in worse shape than anyone thought. There was a rumor that the firm had cancelled the S26 Edge, but now it looks like they might delay the full S26 series because of problems with development. Problems with making the base S26 model may mean that Samsung has to push back the release of its next flagship phones by 2 months. Techmaniacs has a new rumor that says the corporation plans to release the new devices in March of next year. It's not obvious what problems Samsung is having with the S26's development, but the design and development of the gadget are still not finished. But the S26 Ultra is now done and ready to be made. The chipset we expect to see in the Samsung S26 and many more of next year's greatest Android phones should be coming in two versions. And the one that Samsung will use could give its upcoming phones a major early advantage. This material comes from Digital Chat Station on Weibo and involves the Snapdragon 8 Elite Gen 5. That's the currently unconfirmed successor to the Snapdragon 8 Elite that practically every premium Android phone has used this year. And sure, we're just as mystified about where that name came from as you. Digital Chat Station notes in their post that there will be a pair of 8 Elite Gen 5 chips on offer, one with a main frequency of 4.61 GHz and another with 4.74 GHz. That'll be exclusive to Samsung initially, with other companies obtaining access later. Qualcomm has been delivering two versions of its flagship processor for the past few years. There's a simple version available to any manufacturer from the debut of the chip. There's also a quicker version, which arrives on the newer Samsung Galaxy S series early in the new year and then by other firms a few months later. This is frequently promoted as the leading version of the silicon. If we compare the purported 4.61 GHz and 4.74 GHz clock speeds of the Snapdragon 8 Elite Gen 5 to the 4.32 GHz and 4.47 GHz editions of the current Snapdragon 8 Elite, we can plainly see the improved speed between generations for both versions. Hopefully, this will result in a great performance gain for the phones which use it, while also improving the battery economy of devices equipped with it. But whatever benefits the Snapdragon 8 Elite Gen 5 may give, it may not apply equally to all of Samsung's next-gen flagships. It's been claimed that Samsung could equip at least some of their 2026 Galaxy S models with the Exynos 2600. This in-house chip comes from a line that has often been a failure in terms of performance and efficiency, but Samsung clearly isn't willing to give up and attached Snapdragon chips to all S26 models, like it has with prior Galaxy S generations. With a projected release timeframe of January 2026, there's still time for further S26 facts to emerge and explain which of these rumors are real or not. While this news should be taken with a grain of salt, it could turn out correct. The reports about the S26 family are still mixed, which could suggest that the firm is yet to make final judgments about the smartphones. We predict a base model with a new Pro designation, a likely Plus variant, and the top-notch Ultra model. While Samsung hasn't published any official details about the S26, delaying the announcement and launch of its next flagship phones may raise worries. However, what's essential in the end is how excellent the new devices will be. As long as the company doesn't make concessions with the quality, everyone will be delighted, even if they have to wait a bit longer. So that's it for today's video. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more tech news and updates.